Water dumped from Lake Oroville broke apart more of the Oroville spillway today. Tonight, the lake level continues to rise. Good evening, I'm Sam Shane.
And I'm Christina Janes. The challenge for officials now is how best to dump the water from the nearly full reservoir into the Feather River now that the spillway is badly damaged. The state could possibly use an emergency spillway right next to the damaged spillway, but that one has its own set of issues. CBS 13's Drew Balea is live in Butte County with what the Department of Water Resources plans to do next. Drew?
Well, we're really in some uncharted territory right now because this is a situation that has never been dealt with before. We're being told now that the water will be spilling over the emergency spillway in only a few hours.
I hate to have to see him use that emergency spillway.
Greg Mahone has lived below the tallest dam in America since he was born.
Just scared and weird, you know, wondering what they're going to do about it.
He and thousands of others will be on edge the next few days as concerns over the broken and battered spillway continue.
I hope this weather lets up, you know, for a few days so they can get a handle on it.
Engineers with the Department of Water Resources are watching with a close eye from below and above the gaping hole. As lake levels continue to rise, authorities must do something to ease pressure on the dam. So they're releasing water despite the fact that the hole is more than doubled in size, and this is the collateral damage, earth being torn away. Eric C. with the DWR says the water will eventually hit bedrock.
The erosion will essentially stop or slow down greatly at that point. So if that's the case, then we could have use of the existing spillway, which, you know, is what we're hoping for.
All effort is aimed at avoiding an unprecedented move, opening the uncontrolled emergency spillway.
Unless conditions change, we anticipate there may be a release of water over the emergency spillway, maybe sometime on Saturday.
Workers spent the day clearing debris from beneath the emergency spillway, just in case.
If we can push up to 50 or 55,000 on CFS during the next 24 hours, then we think we can reduce or eliminate the need to use the emergency spillway.
In the history of the dam, water has never gone over the emergency spillway. Now, it's only feet away.
In all my years of living here, I would have never imagined it.
And it looks like they're going to try and reduce the amount of water that's going to go over the emergency spillway. As you heard, Saturday morning is when they believe that water will go over the emergency spillway. Right now, we're at about 10 feet away from capacity, but unfortunately, the water flowing into the lake far outpaces the water flowing out.
Now, Drew, quickly, what about the next storm? We're clearly not out of the rainy season just yet.
Yeah, that question was asked today during a news conference, and we were told, well, actually, we weren't given a timeline of when any of the fixes or any of the contingency plans would be put in place, but we were told that they're going to continue using the regular spillway with whatever more moisture that they get until the lake level goes down.
You capitalized it right off the top. We are in uncharted territory here, Drew. Thanks very much. Live for us tonight in Butte County.